Gravity is one of four fundamental forces that shape the universe as we know it. Most people are acquainted with the tale of Newton's indirect apple mishap that led to his significant breakthrough about gravity. As the story goes, whilst lounging under a tree, Newton was allegedly musing about nature's intrinsic forces. This contemplation was suddenly interrupted by an apple falling. This minor occurrence prompted a major revelation. The force that brought the apple downward also operates on a grander scheme, keeping Earth orbiting the Sun. The tale is as colorful as it is fascinating, comprising a remarkable scientific discovery, an act of serendipity, and a profound awareness, all stemming from something as commonplace as an apple's tumble from a tree. Yet this story is somewhat distorted, as is Newton's theory. Contrary to popular belief, it wasn't a hit on the head that sparked Newton's insight. His biographer, William Stukeley, tells us that Newton observed the apple falling while lost deep in thought. He considered the curious question of why the apple didn't fall sideways or in a deviant direction, but instead headed straight for the ground. Newton later hypothesized that the force of gravity, a pull or attraction between two bodies, is proportional to their mass and inversely proportional to the distance between them squared. Furthermore, Newton believed that the trajectory these bodies followed minimized energy expenditure, adhering to a straight line. Newton, however, never fully stood by his own theory, seeing as he had envisioned the force as a push, not an inexplicable pull. Then, the prevailing assumption that gravity's mystical pull is a mass characteristic obscured the truth for four centuries, until another respected genius, Einstein, debunked this concept with his revolutionary General Theory of Relativity. With audacious conviction, this humble patent clerk dared to challenge Newton's revered views, thereby contesting beliefs held sacred for 400 years. Einstein's newfound conception of gravity was predicated on a sequence of thought experiments. Those experiments postulated that there is no distinguishable difference between an astronaut floating in the gravity-free environment of space and the same astronaut free-falling within planetary gravity. In either scenario, the astronaut would be seemingly weightless until subjected to an external force. Such observations led to Einstein's groundbreaking assertion that bodies aren't attracted to massive objects, but rather pushed downward by the space above them. According to Einstein's General Theory of Relativity, matter warps both space and time, collectively termed the space-time continuum. Like an elastic grid, space becomes distorted when a massive object presses down upon it, effectively creating a downward slope. Objects then traverse this inclined path, following the straightest possible trail in curved spacetime. This postulation revolves around the fundamental idea that physical laws stay the same for all observers. Einstein's complex mathematical equations of geodesics reveal that acceleration results from warped spacetime. The model depicts that in the absence of curvature, an object would move linearly with unchanging velocity unless interfered by another force. However, these equations surprisingly omit mass, suggesting that the rate of acceleration doesn't rely on the falling body's mass. Simply put, gravity is not a push or a pull, it is rather the downward curve of space and time. Is Newton's understanding of gravity entirely incorrect, given its widespread usage in academic texts? The answer is no. Though it deviates from Einstein's interpretation, Newton's laws are still invaluable to NASA for predicting satellite behavior. This theory also remains effective for entities of smaller mass and slower speeds. Although the principles of general relativity are highly complex and challenging, they validate that gravity is neither a push nor a pull, but due to the curvature of space and time.